Rising input costs triggered by soaring crude oil prices have dented sentiment of fast-moving consumer goods stocks over the past few weeks. Considered a defensive bet in a turbulent market, investors dumped these counters even as the overall market sentiment remained choppy. This was due to surging crude oil prices, which triggered an upward march in prices of most raw materials used by FMCG companies, which could chip away their margins. Over the last quarter, prices of commodities like palm oil, crude oil, and S&P are up 23% to 42%. At the bourses, the S&P BSE FMCG index has lost nearly 5% as compared to over 3% fall in the S&P BSE Sensex. If analysts are to be believed, there could be more pain ahead for these stocks as crude prices continue to rise amid the geopolitical tensions between Russia and Ukraine. After a 4.5-month freeze, the government bit the bullet and has started to hike prices of petrol and diesel gradually, which analysts say could fuel inflation and force consumers to cut back on their purchases. Besides, the upward revision of fuel prices would also translate into higher freight costs and keep rural demand under pressure. On their part, FMCG companies plan to hike product prices yet again to cope with the rising raw materials cost. But industry incumbents and dealers or distributors have highlighted that Q4 saw further moderation in rural demand due to price hikes. Urban markets too witnessed some demand slowdown. Instead of a recovery in gross margins in fiscal 2022-23, Jefferies now builds in 50 to 200 basis points year-on-year decline, assuming crude oil prices stay closer to $100 a barrel and palm oil at $1,500 per metric ton in FY23. At the fundamental level, GCPL, HUL, ITC, Colgate, Devyani International and Zomato are Jefferies' top picks in the FMCG space. Mumbai-based Antique Stock Broking is bullish on HUL, Dabur and ITC. Let's now go to Business Standard's Abdul Bakr to understand how frontline FMCG stocks look on the charts and whether there are any stocks worth your money at the current levels.
On a wider perspective, Nifty FMCG Index and its constituents and its stocks aren't performing the way they used to perform a few years back. Nifty FMCG index itself is trading below 200 days moving average, a relevant indicator that investor considers as a significant component while investing. The benchmark indices Nifty 50 and Sensex have retrieved back about 200 days EMA after the recent correction, whereas Nifty FMCG index failed to do so. Among FMCG stocks, except ITC, which is on the verge of claiming a new 52-week high. The prior 52-week high was 259.20. It is showing signs that it can cross and stay bullish for some more time. Whereas other stocks like Hindustan Unilever, Dabur, and Colgate Palmolive continues to trade in a negative sentiment. Hindustan Unilever has a resistance of 200 DMA, immediate resistance come to 2200 and it is showing signal that it can fall towards 1800, can even see further decline towards 1700 levels. While Colpal, which is currently trading sideways, may see some positive sign if it holds 1450 levels, which is a crucial support for these stocks.
If you like this video, share it and subscribe to Business Standard. For more news, views and insights, log on to www.business-standard.com. Do also follow us on YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, Telegram and LinkedIn.